Hello everybody. The Indian stock markets have been on an emotional roller coaster ride this past 1 month. We've seen the euphoria, we've seen the depression, we've seen the lackluster attitude of the markets this past 1 month. To help us gain an understanding about the current market scenario, we have with us Dr. VK Vijayakumar, Chief Investment Strategist of Geojit Financial Services. Welcome to the session, sir.
Hi.
So the Indian stock markets are more or less reacting to the economic data, the economic news that is coming out, and the government's reactions to it. Now, it is a fact that we are facing a slowdown because the RBI has downgraded the growth rates, and we expect the world organizations also to follow suit. So how serious is this slowdown? I mean, do we have reason to be worried over here that it will be an extended slowdown that we are facing currently?
Yes, the economic environment is very challenging indeed, but it is very important for us to understand the nature of the problem that we are facing, because some people are referring to this problem that we are facing as a severe economic crisis. Many are referring to this as a recession, and many, like what you said right now, including economists, would prefer to refer to this as a slowdown in the economy. It is important for investors to understand the nature of the problem that we are facing. What we are facing now is not a severe economic crisis. In 1991, we faced a crisis when we had to pledge gold with the Bank of England. We had to approach IMF for a foreign exchange loan. Our credit rating was downgraded to speculative grade. All the fundamentals of the economy were flashing red, fiscal deficit, current account deficit. Inflation was skyrocketing. Mm. There was capital flight from the economy. That was a crisis. After that, towards the end of 1990s, there was a slowdown in the economy. The economy picked up from 93 onwards, but then towards the end of 90s, there was a slowdown in the economy, triggered partly by the Asian currency crisis and all that. Then in 2000, there was the tech bubble crash and the global recession that followed. That global recession impacted India also, and there was a cyclical slowdown in the economy for the 3 years in the early 2000s. Then in 2008, we had the global financial meltdown and the global great recession. India was not very severely impacted by that, but very temporary short period of slowdown. After that, in 2013, after the taper tantrums, there was the foreign exchange crisis. Not a crisis, but then there was capital flight and rupee depreciated sharply. So if you take the last, and now the present slowdown in the economy. So if you take the last 30 years, there has been 5 instances of economic slowdowns in the economy. It is very important to understand that economic growth is not linear. It is cyclical. There will be ups and downs caused by large number of factors, external factors, internal factors, cyclical factors, structural factors. Linear growth. It is cyclical. And right now, we are facing the slowdown. I am not trivializing the slowdown. It is a serious slowdown, particularly in segments like automobiles and real estate. The problem is severe, but then this is a slowdown. It is a temporary slowdown, and we will come out of the slowdown.
Right. So we've seen this. I mean, the government coming out with reforms to bolster demand. Will that be enough? And when do you see the recovery also sort of happening from this slowdown?
Well, it is very difficult to exactly predict the timing of recovery. But I would first explain the probable nature of the recovery. In economics, we talk about a sharp and quick V-shaped recovery and a flat, gradual, slow U-shaped recovery. What we are likely to witness this time is a gradual, slow, flat U-shaped recovery, because as you just now asked in your question, the global environment also is not very favorable. So apart from the economic stimulus that the government is having, implementing right now, we need a favorable global environment also. Right. That is not there, but then a recovery is very much possible. I expect a recovery to begin in the third quarter of this financial year.
And the economic logic behind this timing, if you can explain on that.
Well, the economic logic is mainly threefold. Number one, the RBI has implemented, is in the process of implementing a very massive monetary stimulus. Repo rates are near 10-year low right now. This year itself, RBI has cut interest rates 5 times, the cumulative rate cut of 135 basis points. Of course, the monetary transmission is not good enough, but then it is happening slowly. There are large number of factors responsible for the poor transmission, but then it is happening slowly. In India, monetary policy acts with a lag, a lag of 2 to 3 months. So that's why I said we can expect a recovery in 3 months, 4 months time. That's one thing. Secondly, that also you referred to in your question, the slew of policy measures being implemented by the government, the measures specifically for the automobile industry, for the real estate sector, for the NBFC sector, and more importantly, the cut in corporate tax rates, right? That particularly from the market perspective, it is a big game changer. You will have a very good impact on the markets and the economy on, from a medium term perspective, but the beneficial effects need not be very visible in the very short term. And the third logic, economic logic that you asked about is, this year we had a bountiful monsoon, 10% better than the normal monsoon. So that will have a very benign effect on the rural economy, and we can expect the rural economy and the agriculture economy to do well. So that will provide a boost to consumption demand from the rural segment.
Right. You were talking about the global uncertainties that we are facing. So assuming that, you know, domestically everything is sorted out and it seems to be fine, so will that be enough to boost the economy, or are we dependent more on the global part of the economy also? We are facing a lot of uncertainties with regards to Brexit, with the Trump tweet wars.
That is beyond our control.
The Iran issue sorting out. So will that have an effect on India's economy? Do you think it will have a major impact?
India is not linked to the global economy as much as, let us say, China or South Korea or Taiwan. But of course, we are linked. And if the global economy slows down deeply, very sharply by the end of this year and goes into a recession in 2020, then it's quite possible that that will become a headwind for the Indian economy too. But then there are economists who believe that the aggravation of the US-China trade dispute will throw up opportunities for India, because China is moving out, supply chains, global supply chains are moving out. So if we pull the right strings in India, particularly regarding the labor and land acquisition, etc., that can turn out to be an opportunity for India also.
Right. So now coming back to the stock markets, over the last one and a half years, we've seen the markets the broader markets on a downtrend, especially from the Jan 2018 budget, we've seen the markets coming down. Now, we've always been advising investors to accumulate their investments, either be it in stocks or in mutual funds, and this would have to an extent limited their downside also in this kind of market. But then the fact of the matter is that, you know, investors are an unhappy lot, because, you know, they've seen their investments going negative. Even SIP investments, which was supposed to be one of the better modes of investment for the long term, even the SIP returns have also turned negative. So what would be your advice to them in this market scenario to pacify the investors? What would be your advice?
Our investors have become very mature. I am very pleased to note that the small investor, the retail investor, is showing great faith in the India growth story as well as in the capital market. Look at the SIP investment. Even in this rather negative sentiment environment, the SIP is north of 8,000 crores every month. So that is a reflection of the optimism and maturity of the retail investor. You are right, returns during the last 1 year, 2 years, even 3 years, particularly in the broader market, mid caps, small caps, the returns have been very negative. But then if you look at the journey of the Sensex from 100 in 1979 to 37,000 now, you will find that there have been periods, sometimes extended periods of poor performance for the market. Right. Sometimes 3 years, 4 years, 5 years of a stagnation in the market. Right. Therefore, the only solution to the problem is to show faith and show great patience with your investment. Now, I would like to add a couple of points here. One is a bear market. This is not a bear market. Technically, it is not a bear market because a bear market should qualify as a 20% correction from the peak. It has not happened. But then sentiments are a little bit bearish. Markets also are exhibiting some characteristics of bearishness. But then when sentiments are negative like this, it provides opportunities to discerning investors to move from inferior quality stocks to quality stocks. In every portfolio, there will be some dud stocks, what we call cats and dogs. And then this is the time when quality stocks are fetching premium in the market. And during bad times, quality stocks will be available at attractive valuations. So investors should use this opportunity to move to quality stocks, right? And also another point is mid and small caps, as you said, negative returns for 2 years?
2 years.
No, 2 years, even more than that. But then if you take 2017, in 2017, the mid and small cap segment delivered excellent
40,
returns.
Mutual funds were giving 40%.
More than 40%, yes. Small caps more than 50%. Yes, that is irrational exuberance. And that that actually created a situation where the mid caps were having valuation premium to the large caps.
Right.
Now it is just the reverse. Yeah. The valuation of mid and small caps are at a steep discount to the large caps. Right. So this cannot continue for long. So again, we cannot say when the mid and small caps will come back to fancy. So this will be a good time to allocate some more money to mid and small caps, but it should be done through the systematic investment through the mutual funds, not through direct stock selection. So whatever might be the nature of the market, bearish or bullish, there will always be opportunities for discerning investors. And investors should be exploiting these opportunities.
Right, sir. Thank you very much for that, sir.
Thank you.